Hey, it's Pete. Welcome back to my workshop. This week, I'm going to get a computer set up. I'm going to get Centroid CNC12 installed on it, and we're going to get it talking to Acorn. And hopefully, we're going to get to see a stepper motor move. All right, we're going to go through the process of setting up this computer to install the Acorn CNC software. And I've got the PDF in front of me here with all the configuration instructions. I've previously gone through and I've checked that this machine does, in fact, meet the minimum requirements of being a CNC computer. And I already know, actually, I just finished running the Windows updates, so I don't need to do that. And I also know that the account that I'm currently using has administrator rights. So I don't need to do anything there. So first thing we need to do is go down to the system and security, and we're going to be turning off some stuff here that might interfere with the Acorn communication. So go into system and security, security and maintenance, and then scrolling down here, we're going to go into the change security and maintenance settings, and we're going to be clearing out all these checkboxes to prevent some pop-up messages and things that might occur in normal operation. So I'm going to get rid of all that. Scrolling down here, we're going to go and change account control. We're going to turn this all the way down to never notify. And we're going to have to say yes to that because that is an administrative thing. And then we're going to go back to Windows Defender Firewall. And we are going to turn the Windows Defender Firewall off. So that's there and right there. And say OK. That gets us there. And then finally, we're going to go back here and we're going to go into power options. Power options. We're already in high performance mode. We're going to go in here, turn the display off, computer sleep never. We want to change some advanced settings. This hard disk, we want to set this to zero so that it never shuts off. And that'll say never when we click away. We're also going to want to check the USB settings, make sure selective suspend is disabled. And what else do we have in here that we need to do? Sleep, we already have that turned off. Sleep after never. We'll just turn this off. Hybrid after never, allow wake timers. And anything else in here? Now I think, and we've got the processor already set, maximum display, turn off after, it should be never. Okay, so we're good here. Get out of there. And then finally, we're going to go back here. And we want to go to the clock and region setting and set time and date. Head over here to internet time. And we want to change these settings. We want to turn that off so that it does not go out on the internet trying to update its time settings. So where are we at here? Anything else? Uninstall programs. I actually know that this is already a minimal build system, so we don't really need to do anything there. So I think that that is, we'll go ahead and have a look at this here. Most of this stuff in here is required for this machine. And a lot of it doesn't do. We got some Mitsubishi stuff in here and some Yaskawa Electric stuff. But yeah, I think mostly we're in good shape here. All right, I've got the Acorn board plugged in, powered up, and I have the Ethernet cable connected over to my computer. We're going to go ahead and unzip this to the desktop. Okay, that's good. And then we're going to go in here and see what we've got. Just a single setup file. This is just a pop-up message from Windows Defender complaining that it's not available. And we'll agree. And we'll say next. And we're going to choose CNC 12 mil. Let this install. And next, network adapter setup. Say yes. Successfully set Ethernet adapter. Finish. And let's try running it. And it communicated with the Acorn. It's rebooting. And so there we go. We successfully set up this computer to talk to the Acorn. So I've gone ahead and I've made the connection for this stepper motor to the X-axis drive on our control board. Now, this is actually the Z-axis motor, but they're all the same. And when hooking these up, you have the option of either wiring them in series mode or parallel mode. For our application here, we're going to have to run them in series because the G251X Gecko drive can't quite put out enough power to run these in parallel mode. Next thing I need to do is get into the Centroid CNC software and make a few configuration changes specifically for the enable signal to get these drives running. All right, I'm going to fire up the Centroid CNC 12 mil software and I'm going to make some changes to the configuration. I've got my Acorn board plugged in and it's hooked to the network, so we should be able to talk to it here. And we're good. And then I need to go to this utility setting here, go to the Acorn wizard. And what I need to do is on these particular drives, the enable signal is actually a disable signal, so I have to invert the function in the setup system here. So what I need to do is under axes and advanced, I need to go to the axis signal inversion and I have to invert the enable signal for all the axes. And then just write these settings to CNC control. Say yes. Settings are saved. And I can get out of here. And now on the screen, I should be able to choose fast or slow jog. And if we hit our x-axis, we should be able to make this motor run. All right, I'm going to pull you in tight for a close-up here. All right, so I'm going to select our speed here. We're set up for slow jog. And now I should be able to jog this axis. And fast speed. Excellent. All right, one quick thing worth mentioning here. When I installed the software, following along in the instructions, you're told to connect the Acorn board to the computer and power it up before you begin the setup. And if you don't do that, then the setup software cannot go in and set up your network adapter properly. You can go in and check that. I just usually like to right-click network, go to properties, and then this is the this computer actually has two network cards. This is the one that's currently connected to the Acorn board. So if you click on that, go down to properties, and then what you want to do is scroll down here till you see the Internet Protocol version 4, TCP IP v4. You don't want the v6, you want the v4. Highlight that and then go to properties, and you'll see here where the setup software has actually given this a static IP address of 10.168.41.1, and that's what you need to have in there for the computer to be able to successfully talk to the Acorn. So if that's not in there, you can set this manually just by changing from automatic to dedicated, and then go ahead and enter these values.
Well, that went pretty well. I got everything done that I wanted to, and it was great to see that stepper motor move. Now I'm going to be able to take everything and integrate them into the cabinets, get everything wired up for real. And if you like this kind of content, please remember to like, share, and subscribe. It really helps the channel out. I'll catch you next week.